Film vor mir. Ein Film zu sehen. Sehr lecker. Placement of photos very bad. I'm going to cover the back.
As you can see, this section does not agree with our statement that the force was still with the huge human. However, this is due to the player's hand. The human's hand is not stable like a wall, it's only up to the wall on the floor. Please cover your hand, the fact that your hand is pushing the ball downwards. And you see that you leave on the floor after pushing the ball downwards. Because there is no fluctuating in the ground. And the basketball hits the ground, yes, it takes place. The air pressure inside the floor, basketball is very elastic. The elasticity of the ball and conservation of the energy of the ball. This is because when the ball hits the ground, in a perfect condition, there will be 100% elastic motion. The total kinetic energy of the system is conserved in this condition. The collision between the basketball and the ground in our real world is about 80% elasticity. So 80% of the energy is conserved. The other 20% is converted to thermal and kinetic. Thermal and sound energy when we hear the ball bouncing sound. The kinetic energy for the rebounder is then transferred to potential energy as the ball bounces on the floor to the height of the hand. When the basketball returns on the bounce, it doesn't reach the height of the hand. It's because of the energy being lost through thermal and sound. As you can see, Newton's third law, for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Also, the air pressure inside the basketball also greatly affects the density of the ball. Air is a gas, and gases are in constant motion colliding with the other, and the walls inside a fixed volume of the ball. When the basketball is revoked, it hits a floor and a floor. The effect on the basketball causes the basketball to indent, which is to flatten the grid. And this happens when the volume of the ball is compressed, causing the air particles in the ball to become more tightly packed together, which causes the air particles to collide at much greater speeds. This causes the ball to inflate back to its original volume and rebound off the in the air. During this collision, such a kinetic energy is lost to transfer to thermal energy. Okay, now, as seen from this graph, this is shooting. As seen from this graph,
it's so high,
the height displacement. The height displacement of the ball increases to height non-linearly. With decreasing height increase,
it will
start to around 455. Okay, this is the velocity displacement of the ball. The machine, when you throw the ball into the field. As seen from this graph, the length of the displacement, there is not much change in the rate of displacement of the this is due to Newton's first law of motion. According to this law, when there's no resultant force, the object will either remain at rest or continue to with the same velocity. As if on the ball moves with the same displacement, this is due that to being no resultant force in the axis. Since gravity only acts in the vertical direction. Also, just now, the fact that the force of T increases and increases is because the constant force of gravity, which is 10 meters per second squared. By Newton's second law of motion, since there's a resultant force of 10 meters per second squared at the ball, the ball will decrease in velocity and increase. The ball will increase in velocity while ascending even by 10 meters per second squared. And when descending, will decrease with the speed, increase in velocity with the same amount.
They copy everything there.
You only show the
what the fuck?
You only show the
what the fuck?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you.